level. Plural subject. Plural subject. Plural verb. Singular subject. Singular subject. Plural verb. Then plural subject. Singular verb. So dear students, in today's topic we have clearly understood, I hope, with that of the auxiliaries, which is also called as helping verbs. So when I was in explanation with the helping verbs, we need to learn even these things I told you, that is be form or have or do, even model also. Then how come we are going to make use? That is important. Of course, we have even gone through singular and plural form along with the persons, singular person, three persons, that is first person, second person, third person, singular, plural, singular, plural, singular and plural. So that singular, plural has got some four rules which are applicable, that is singular subject. If you are going to make use of singular subject, we will use singular verb. If you are going to make use of plural subject, we will use plural verb. If you are going to make use of singular subject, then plural verb, not singular verb. When we are going to make use of plural subject, singular verb, not plural verb. So as I am telling you this, what kind of verb it is, main verb we are using or the helping verb? So this it will be clarified to you in the next class of grammar with the same topic. So till then, let us be safe and wait for the next class. Okay, take care. So welcome to the class, dear students. Hope in the previous class you might have learned about the helping verbs, what we have gone through. So now let me tell you, genius you all are. Genius is one who shoots at something where no one else can see and hit. Got? Genius are those people who are going to shoot at that thing which an ordinary person cannot see. It means, why I want to tell this to you means, you all are genius. And you keep it in mind what we have told. And dear students, a request to you all, whatever we are teaching to you or explaining, please listen with concentration and go through it clearly. If you have any doubts, you can call us. We are here to help you. Okay? Language is also something which promotes to your percentage. So let us talk that later. But because you can't neglect language also, if you have a proper, good, grammatically correct vocabulary, you can click anywhere. Why? Because unfortunately or fortunately, you are called to give some seminars or something or talk on some topics. Of course, you are a dynamic speaker. But if you lag these things, then somebody may say, every person has got weakness, but it doesn't mean that we have to expose our weakness. We have to hide it. In this, when we are going to say or commit any mistake, they are going to catch hold. Watchdogs they are always. So dear, let us learn properly with the things, because the nature of mankind or the mind is that it always moves in a wrong direction. Okay? like a wild horse without a reins. Okay? Nature of man is, in that way, it is going to mean a wrong direction. As the horse without reins. So let us not be that. Let us clearly concentrate on the topics that we are promoting you to learn. So the only thing what you have to do is full-fledged concentration. So right? And before we start this, let me bring to your notice. In English, you have got a workbook. I think I have told you in some of the videos in the beginning that you are having along with the textbook course book, you are also having workbook which goes with the name Streams. Okay, so you have to have that book. The models, the examples, whatever shown with explanation is given in the workbook to you all. So dear students, you have that workbook. We are going to explain you here. You can fill that. And we are going to inform you. So at that time you can bring that books and get it corrected when you are going to get your assignments. When you are going to get your core subjects assignment, please get the workbook also after completion, not empty book, after completion. Okay? Hope you have understood. As I told you, genius you people are. So okay, genius, let us learn. So in the previous class, I was telling you singular subject, verb is also singular. How come? So what I did, what I told you all, when singular verb means that singular verb is a main verb or a helping verb. So okay, singular verb means it is a singular verb, main verb or a helping verb. We get confused. So now let me little brief you. See, he, it, or he eating. See how odd it is. He eating what? Grass. He eating. So okay, whatever he eats, it is left to the eater. So it is he is. See, singular subject, singular helping verb. The rule applied. Singular subject, singular verb. We are not told that in the rule, if the singular subject is singular, verb must be singular. Of course, here it is there. Here the main verb is there. But the main verb is incomplete. The sentence with the main verb in the ing form is incomplete or wrong unless and until you don't make use of the main verb, helping verb is. Singular subject, present tense. So, as according to the first rule, singular subject, singular verb. We are not talking about the main verb or the helping verb here. So, what we are talking? That when the subject is singular, you want to use the singular verb. So, what we have used here. Then you may get a confusion and ask, so main verb is also there? Dear, of course there. Of course it is there, but let me tell you, it is not in the form of this. It is accompanied with ing, which is a gerund form, also called as ing form or ing form, gerund form, present participle form. So okay, they are okay. So hence, the rule is there. According to the rule, it is correct or not, that we have to see. It is correct now. He is eating. If I use, he are eating. No, it is not possible. Then singular subject, singular verb, it is not there. Now it is okay. So now let us come for the second rule. Plural subject. Plural verb. Plural verb. How come? Now let us. They are playing.
they are playing. So see this example. Plural subject. Subject is plural here. They, not singular. They. Then what? The main verb is play here. But play is in ing form, gerund form, present participle form. So the, if we don't use that verb, they playing. Of course, understood. The sentence is conveying the meaning. But wrong. The sentence is no doubt conveying you the meaning. But not complete meaning with the sense. When you are going to use this are, then it is complete. See, they are playing. So as according to the rule, plural subject, plural verb. Clear students? Last 2 points. It means last 2 rules. How they are? Let me come. Singular subject. Singular subject. He or she. Singular subject. Plural verb. And now comes the confusion. Singular subject, plural verb. What plural verb? It is helping verb or main verb. So here, we don't make use of main verb with the third person singular. He is third person singular. She. Okay. She sing. What sing? Song. She sing. Is it correct? She sing. Correct. It may be correct. You will be in a confusion, in a dilemma. Correct or not? Wrong or right? So, she sings. To the rule of grammar. Singular subject, plural verb. How can it be? Why can't we use they sings? Wrong. Why? The rule is there. Another rule is there. She sings. See, dear students, the third rule, singular subject, plural verb. Subject is singular, verb is plural. And another question or confusion may arise to you all by saying that there is no use of any helping verb here. No use of helping verb. When you make use of helping verb, then you are going to change this main verb. She is. We are going to bring this into ing form. That is another matter about the tense. Let us not go to that. Let us understand only this much. She is singing. That is tense, in tense form. We are not talking tense here. We are talking about the usage of. That is, we are talking about the usage of subject verb agreement. We are talking about the usage of subject verb agreement. Because the subject is singular, the verb must be plural. If the subject is plural, the verb will also be plural. That is the previous rules what we have done. She sings. This is according to this rule. Also, this sentence is used in simple present. Simple present. Or present indefinite. Present indefinite tense. So again, it is also called as simple present tense or present indefinite tense. See here, she sings. When we are going to make use of this sentence in tense form. When we are going to make use of this sentence in tense form, then this tense is known as simple present tense or present indefinite. Right? Simple present tense or present indefinite. In present indefinite or simple present tense, we don't make use of helping verb which is not applicable. Another rule is that always we are going to make use of S for singular. This is third person singular. Now let us come for another rule. That is plural subject. Plural verb.
plural verb? How can it be used? So sorry, this is plural subject, singular verb. Sorry, extremely plural subject, last rule, plural subject, singular verb. How can it be possible? Plural subject, they. Where it is? Plural subject is there. Plural verb, singular verb is, singular subject will be there. Plural verb we have done. Singular subject, plural verb. I think we have done plural subject, plural subject, plural verb we have done. Singular plural subject, plural verb. They are singing. I have not shown that example. They are. So this is plural subject, plural verb. Plural subject, plural verb. They are. Another rule is there. Plural subject, singular verb. So how can it be? So in which tense we are going to make use of that? So four rules what we have: plural, singular subject, singular verb, plural subject, plural verb, singular subject, plural verb. It means he sings. Likewise, plural subject, singular verb. Let us see. They, plural subject, go, singular, to the farm. They goes to the farm, you can't write. He goes, you can use he goes. Because singular subject, plural verb. For that it is applicable. When we are going to make use of plural subject, singular verb, means they go to the farm. You can't use they goes to the farm. And of course, if it is in past tense, they went to the farm. This is past. They gone to the farm, that is not the right way. That is used in different sense. Okay. Now let us have these four things, that is four rules of grammar. That is singular subject, singular verb, plural subject, plural verb, singular subject, plural verb, plural subject, singular verb. So let us have this. Let us know this much. You, as I already told you, we need not, while doing the helping verb, there is no much knowledge required to deeply get penetrated. So what we need to know, we need the basic things to be understood clearly, so that you can do one thing, that is what we are, you are having from the examination point of view in your workbook, as well as the part of grammar, which is therefore 3 marks that will be there for 3 marks. For 3 marks you need to learn this much, of course, dear students. Unless and until you don't get proper background knowledge of the, or the basic knowledge of the usage of the helping verbs or the tense or the prepositions, whatever they are, you will never come to the point correctly. So this knowledge is needed. Hence we are going. For what it is needed? Now the question comes. For what it is needed? For what it is needed? Is there any question in relation to this? Of course, it is. Which question? So again, we learn about the voices. Let us learn about the voices. Let us see one example of this in relation to that. And let us later know the other things. Now see, complete the following. One example, let me show you. Complete the following by filling the blanks. Filling in the blanks. Using the right form of the verb.
have learned about the verbs. Right? Complete the following. An extract will be given, dear students. And in that, you are to fill the blanks using the form of the verbs. They are not asking. They are not saying you the form of the verbs. What they are saying you? See, concentrate on every line. Fill in the blanks using the form of the verbs. There is a difference, a huge difference. Saying form of the verbs, saying right form of the verbs. Got it? So I have closed a bit there. Saying right form of the verbs. What is the right form of the verbs? Now let us see. One, let us learn from the extract. Okay? The contemporary seeds were dash in the bracket. So when the living earth into dead matter to facilitate the industrial revolution. The industrial revolution, monocultures dash replace diversity, So this is an example from your grammar learning point of view. So what I told you, complete the following by filling the blanks using the right form of the verbs. This extract, first of all, from where it will be given, you may get confused. So dear students, let me once again tell you, whatever the extracts that will be given in grammar, so either it will be given from your very lessons or from unfamiliar passage. Possibilities are there. So let us not get cracked to that. It is not so hard as you crack on that. It is very easy. You need not. The only condition is that you have to have full-fledged concentration. I am repeating again and again. Unless until you don't concentrate, there you cannot fill properly. So now, let us go to that back. The contemporary seeds were dash. So already here, seeds were is already given in the extract. Now let us think that it is not given. Let us think that it is not given. Contemporary seeds dash. So when the living earth dash transform into dead matter, facilitate the industrial revolution, monocultures dash replace diversity. So this is given. So how come we are going to, let me complete this example with that of the helping verbs. Later I will tell you what exactly this topic is related. So unless and until we are not going to know about the helping verb properly, we will be failing or we will be in a dilemma to which verb to insert before we are going to write the main verb. So only, first let us understand with one example
with the helping verbs. Then let us go with other example with the voices. The contemporary seats, not singular, seats, so many verb. So contemporary seats were, now what you are going to do? Sown, S-O-W-N. The contemporary seeds sown, if you do this also, when the living earth was earth singular, this is plural, so were is used, singular, so was is used. Living earth was transformed. Transformed into dead matter to facilitate the industrial revolution. Mono of course simple, single, cultures plural verb. Replaced diversity. Okay, now what we have to understand here is that how we have made use of the helping verbs. That is what we need first. We need first. Later you can. When you are clearly understanding the proper use of the helping verbs, then you can do it properly. So that properly is still to be done. Very clear cut, crystal cut manner. Let us learn in the next class with that of the voices. The next topic, voices, which is also deeply related to this very topic. Hope you have understood here with that of the helping verbs. In the next topic, which is closely in relation to the topic that was written, complete the following with the right form of the verbs. The next will be your voices, not that voice what we are having, but it is different. Hope with this also you might have clearly understood. So again I tell you, understand properly, do it properly, you are genius. Okay, take care. Let us meet in the next class with voices. Bye.